Today, our art project is going to be based on this beautiful book called Handa's Surprise by Eileen Brown. Handa put 7 delicious fruits in a basket for her friend Akeo. Look at all these beautifully colored fruits. Reds and oranges, greens and yellows, purples. Delicious. She will be surprised, thought Handa, as she set off for Akeo's village. I wonder which fruit she'll like best. Will she like the soft yellow banana? Oh, what can you see happening? Who's this in the tree that's watching her walk by? The cheeky monkey is stealing the banana right out of Handa's basket, and she doesn't even know. Or the sweet smelling guava. Who's stealing the guava? Yes, it's a hungry ostrich. Will she like the round, juicy orange? Who's stealing the orange? It's Mr. Zebra. Or the ripe red mango. This elephant is using his long trunk to sneakily steal the mango. Will she like the spiky-leaved pineapple? And this giraffe is using his tongue to grasp onto the leaves of the spiky pineapple and whip it out of her basket. Now, actually, if you didn't know, a giraffe's tongue is actually designed to be able to handle spiky things. So the pineapple is easy for the giraffe to steal. The creamy avocado. The buck is stealing the avo. Or the tangy purple passion fruit. Can you see the parakeet sitting in the top of the tree, keeping his eye on the basket that Handa's got on her head? And he swoops down and he plucks this passion fruit right out of her basket. Another name for passion fruit is the granadilla. And now, what do you think is happening? She seems to be getting close to Akeo's village, because now we can see a goat. And this goat has been tied to a post. And he escapes, he breaks free from the post. And he goes charging into a big tree full of tangerines. And all the tangerines come falling into Handa's basket. Which fruit will Akeo like best? Hello, Akeo, said Handa. I've brought you a surprise. Tangerine, said Akeo. My favorite fruit. Tangerines, said Handa. That is a surprise. What a funny thing to happen. Who do you think got more of a surprise? Akeo or Handa? I think it was Handa, because that's not what she put in her basket when she left home that morning, is it? So I think that it was Handa who got the biggest surprise. Now that you've read Handa's surprise, you're going to choose your favorite animal. Think of an animal you absolutely love. We're going to start our picture by drawing a border. Take a ruler's width and go all the way around. For our border, we're going to do an animal print. So I've decided to do zebra stripes because I absolutely love zebras. To do zebra stripes, you are going to just do wiggly lines that lead to a point Some of them come up, some of them start down. Long ones, short ones, they almost look like flames. And they kind of connect with each other, but without touching. Sometimes they long like that, they go right across. Sometimes there's two or three together, long ones and maybe a short one there. And then they come from the top and the bottom, just like that. So if you want to do zebra stripes, that is how you do them. So to do leopard spots, you're just doing what we call a rosette. Some are big, some are small. And on a leopard, they're actually brown spots, believe it or not, with black inside. So I'm going to time lapse the rest for you so that you can see me draw my border. And then I'm going to color them in. And that's our border done. So take a look. Now for this project, I've said that you could choose any animal that you liked, as long as it was a South African animal, perhaps one that you would find if you were going on a safari or game drive. So for my picture, I've decided that I'm going to draw a giraffe. And a giraffe has got a very interesting shaped face. It's got two horns, so we need to start with those. Now, to avoid having a tiny little giraffe in a big space over there, we're going to use the finger spacing technique just to make sure that we space out our picture nicely. We're going to do one horn there and one horn there, two finger spaces away from the top of our border. Now the horns are kind of round, almost tube shapes. So start off with the horns. It's probably about two finger space distance between each horn, just roughly, and try and get them to look about the same size and about the same width. That's the thickness. And then you're going to draw the top of the giraffe's head and you're going to join the little horns up. The face is quite a long face, so it's going to go down like that and then in a little bit, and it's going to come down to the nose area there. Whatever you do on one side, you're going to do on the other side. So you need to be using a little bit of what we call symmetry for this project. And symmetry is when one side is the same as the other side. Right, we've got the shaped face of the giraffe, and the giraffe is looking at us. So his nose is going to be right in front, and the middle of the nose needs to kind of line up with the middle of the head. So it's a little lump up there and a little lump up there. Those are kind of the beginning of his nostrils, and then it comes in a little bit on each side, and from there about maybe 2 or 3 millimeters, just a little gap from the bottom of the nose up to about there. You're now going to close up and do the chin. What this is kind of like the chin of the giraffe here. And we're going to do the same on this side. If it's not perfect, please don't worry. Remember that there are no real mistakes in art. And if you're not happy with something, you can always just rub it out. And then we're going to do two sort of tear shape, like almost water droplets for the nostrils. And then obviously the mouth of the giraffe kind of goes over there, but we don't want him looking so sad. So you can kind of do his face, his mouth kind of turning up on the side like that. Now these aren't quite the right angle, so I'm going to fiddle with them a little bit until I'm happy with them. Okay, and then obviously a giraffe has lovely ears on the side, and the ears kind of go like this shape and then down, and the same on this side, out and up and out to the side and then kind of rounded and down. And again, guys, if you're not happy with what you've done, you can always redo it. So have a little fiddle. What I always do when I'm drawing is I always use a reference picture, which just helps me to get the right shapes of my animals that I'm drawing. So for this project, I'm actually using a picture of a giraffe that I found online, and you can use any picture that you find. Perhaps it's one from a magazine, perhaps it's a photograph of an animal that you saw when you were last in a game reserve or on safari. It could be one off the internet or Pinterest. Any reference picture is always a useful thing to have. Now you need to do his long neck. So I am going to kind of go all the way down to the bottom of my paper here, because obviously I'm not drawing the whole giraffe. And then obviously his eyes are quite interesting, because he's got beautiful long eyelashes and big eyes. So we're going to draw an ellipse shape, okay, which is the same shape that you would use if you were drawing a human eye. But for the giraffe, because his eyes are so big and they're such a big feature of him, we're going to draw them a little bit bigger and a little bit bolder, and a little bit rounder than we would do a human eye. Now this one is a little bit of a different shape and a little bit of a different size. That's okay. Just fiddle around a little bit, rub out if you have to, that's okay. And then he's also got a little bit of a eyelid that goes on the top like that, and you can draw his nice big eyes that go in the middle like that. And now giraffes are famous for their eyelashes, so you can give nice long eyelashes. Now if you were drawing a rhino or an elephant or a lion, you're obviously going to look at features of those animals that make them special and make them stand out from other animals. So just remember when you're drawing to add that character of your animal to your drawing. So a giraffe has often got little tufts on the end of his horns. And so I'm going to just draw some little tufts. And guys, you can do this just in pencil if you want to, or if you want to, you can paint your picture, you can use oil pastels. How you draw and color in your picture in the middle of your frame is entirely up to you for this project. I just want to see that you've observed the picture of your animal closely and you've had a good look at what it looks like and all its features, and that you've given it a little bit of its own character. So there we have it, guys, our giraffe. It's a very simple giraffe, and just for fun I'm going to add some color to it. And if you want to, you can do the same, or you can leave it in pencil. Now for this project, what I thought was quite fun was perhaps we could do some trees or some grass. Now if you're doing a lion's face or a rhino's face, maybe they're peeking through some long grass. I can't do grass for the giraffe. If I do grass, it's way below a giraffe's neck. So if I'm doing a giraffe, maybe I want to do a couple of acacia trees in the background. Giraffes with their heads in the trees, nibbling on those delicious acacia leaves. Remember, you can do what you like. Paint, oil pastels, or whatever you have at home to do your picture is absolutely fine. And there you have it, guys, your wildlife picture. Even though you're copying from a reference picture, remember to make it your own. Have fun, enjoy being creative, and we'll see you again soon.